Road safety campaigners have attributed the increase in road carnage to ineffective and outdated legal framework to facilitate strict enforcement, among others. In the road safety policy amendments, they are suggesting that a hit and run scheme be included for the government to cater for victims who are knocked and left in a bad state on the roads by unidentified drivers without any help.
The hit and run cases are very many, so we are pushing it to ensure that the motor party insurance compensation policy can cater for those people that have been hit and run, because it is impossible to trace the people that have knocked them. So we have to ensure that government should cater for them and create a hit and run scheme that can cater for such.
Speaking to journalists in Kampala during the road safety engagement, the executive director of Uganda Road Accident Reduction Network Organization, Fred Tumwine, said that drink driving should also be made a riskier venture for the culprits.
As one of the risk factors, when you are drunk, your decision to be safe on the road is marginalized. So we advocate for drinking, not driving, or if you drive, don't.
With the ongoing road construction works in the country, Tumwine demanded that the roads be widened to include walkways for the pedestrians and bicycle lanes.
So one, the road is supposed to have the carriageway and also sidewalks where people walk, and these sidewalks are safe for people, especially crossing children, cattle keepers who run after, who look after cattle, then wheelbarrow pushers. It should contain all aspects of walking.
The activists also want government not to only rely on road transport, but also bring in other alternative transport means.
Uganda has only a concentration on use of groundwork, which is roads, and yet we have not exhausted the other alternatives of multimodal approach, like railways, like having monotrams or skytrams, and yet we have the capacity of people in this country who can. Chumatech itself is up to that. We are trying to propose another alternative to use the existing road reserve, but also use the existing road separators and put their structures which can move.
President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni signed into law the Traffic and Road Safety Amendment Bill 2023, increasing the fine from 200,000 shillings to 2 million shillings for motorists driving beyond the prescribed speed limit. According to government, the move is intended to restore sanity and reduce on-road carnage on Uganda's roads. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.